Pope Francis appointed 7 female members this week to a Vatican department. 6 women are heads of the religious institutes, and 1 leads a women's secular institute. They're part of the 23 new members of the Congregation for Institutes of Consecrated Life and Societies of Apostolic Life. The appointments break with past practices of an all-male department. Many say it's a result of Pope Francis' call to put women in leadership positions within the Vatican. Joining us now is Solene Tadie, European correspondent for the National Catholic Register. Welcome back to the broadcast, Solene. What message is the Holy Father trying to send by appointing these women?
Well, it is the very first time that women are appointed to this congregation that used to be an all-men congregation made of cardinals, bishops, and priests. The Pope has called many times for a greater space to women within the church authorities. As he said that if the church were to lose women, it could become sterile. So it looks like it is another sign of the Pope's strategy within the church over the past few years. And actually the Roman Curia is currently working on different ways to promote responsibilities for women within the church. And they are currently working on a reform of the Curia through councils of cardinal, and they are discussing these matters currently.
So to follow up on that, what is the advantage for the Vatican in promoting more women and putting them in key positions like these?
I've been interviewing several women with high responsibilities within the Vatican, and they all told me that they feel that complementarity and otherness are a great strength in dealing with the church affairs. They have the feeling, they are convinced, that they can bring a special contribution to the church through their specific sensitivities and experiences. And they also told me that they see the human frailty on a different way with respect to men. And so they think they can give a special contribution also in solving many delicate affairs, such as the crisis of sexual abuse. And they also told me that there is the gift of acceptance is a more feminine, female value than a male value. So they have the feeling that they could be very helpful in the life of the employees within the Vatican, as they also are good spiritual directors. This is what they told me.
Okay, and so then when you think about these women in particular, what stands out to you when you look at the women who have been appointed to this position?
Well, when I see them, I see they have different backgrounds, and many of them, 6 of them, are running important female congregations. So this specific background and experience could be very, very valuable for the church. And I also see that a consecrated laywoman was appointed, which seems to be a sign that the church wants to be more coherent with the fact that since the 1967, the church recognizes the various forms of consecrated lives.
And we've been hearing so much about how the Holy Father wants to include more women in key roles, key leadership positions in the church. So it's interesting to see him carrying that out. So Lynn Tadie, European correspondent for the National Catholic Register. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.